starting not PS2, I'm going to make a post to they played Rock, Paper, Scissors, they did the whole thing.
Stage strike mode?
Yeah.
Well, I do that all the time with ATs. Because AT isn't actually tends to be successful.
Ooh! Gosh.
Oh my god.
Tony.
What is going into this with us?
And what he's proving is that Tony belongs on this one.
He is making a pretty strong argument.
He's got a really pretty compelling case here.
I think, unfortunately, Tony is a player where, like, if he gets something crazy, he might get through it. I fall into that. But
So that was a thing that just happened. I hate that's a thing.
Oh my god. Yeah, that was a fast game. I know Falcon does so much psychic damage, you know what I mean? If he lands a couple smash attacks on you,
How dare I get hit by that?
Yeah, exactly. So when you get hit by two in a row, I would get close.
Stop the battle!
But you gotta reel yourself back in. You can't let that get to your head. And then two times it looked like... The first one maybe was a bumper air dodge, or just a really reasonable one either way. Effectively an SD. The second one... Also an SD, but I guess he was kind of pushed in that direction. But again, after that first dog, he was just playing so scared. Where'd they go? Smashville. I actually don't agree with the Smashville thing. If you ever sit on that platform against Falcon, he will just up. And if he is rising underneath you, you have to respect him. Especially because I saw a little bit earlier in the first game. He's pretty ready to pull the trigger on that up if he ever sees it.
It is his favorite.
He understandably, right? Like,
he pulls it out as often as he can, especially in ever since. It gets him punished a whole lot. But not what I play, it's not a bad game.
But at the same time, like, it is its own built-in mix-up, you know? Because you either don't shield and you get hit by a Falcon Strike and just die by a Falcon Strike.
And the amount of delay on that beat is such that you actually have to think about when you respond to a Falcon.
It has a rather generous boss, I would say.
Look at that!
Yeah, the fact that he can reverse it like that too, it's just a really good option. So you get punished for it a few times.
Tony, though, is doing a whole lot better this game.
Yeah.
Good to fall off, winning a drop.
And right there, you saw him fan the footscore right on top of the wall. And that's kind of what he's been doing. It to good effect this game.
He got the spike right into a whole lot. I don't think it's the strongest spike in the game, but it's in contention.
Definitely up there.
Let's go, Tony.
That is probably about as easy it gets.
The thing about calling the thing about calling Byleth's spike the strongest spike is that you don't get it at zero. So you only get it at percents where weaker spikes will kill anyway. The actual contender for all of the
air dodge. But it kind of frame trapped into itself, didn't it? It was a poor air dodge for Tony, but
I think it frame trapped into itself because of the air dodge.
Yeah.
That should not
we be. Got to witness it actually for the triple smash.
the strongest spike that's not a like a suicide up B killer is actually one to zero is either Wolflash or
up there.
Actually,
up
yeah, the pilot down there might be strong.
Ooh, Tony, be careful. Oh! Oh no!
Captain Waugh tried to down air Tony's Fire Wolf.
It's not Fire Wolf.
I think it is Fire Wolf, actually. He tried to down air Tony's upbeat, but mistimed it and got hit by the upbeat, and then got stage spiked and just died.
Yeah,
and just vanished. And then because Waugh went for that down air, I thought.
You have to play us.
And we're going to play after Austin is done with his singles match because Barros doesn't want to fuck the bracket.
Okay, I'll just wait out there.
Which is good.
Honestly,
one, go!
Are we playing now?
Wait. After
yeah.
Wait until after this one game.
Yeah, this is game three. So we're gonna be.
Okay. Ooh, good sour backwards downer. It covered a lot. Really, really rare approach with that second.
Having watched him, not like this. There's the upbeat good spot dodge from Tony.
Oh
and
my!
Dashback
gosh.
Delayed F smash catches Waugh either jumping or upbeating. Did something out of shield.
He jumped. He saw it kind of wind up a little bit. Thought maybe he had enough time to get back. But
well, he didn't. So.
Ooh, I like the idea that Tony just went for. He just had to dash a little bit.
This is Waugh's other massive weakness. He loves coming down.
First hit Nair specifically. So, okay.
Something about like, they're always make Nair save. But they're huge hits and they do a whole lot of like damage, but if you're paying attention, juggling, you can just beat them.
Oh.
Good spacing.
Yeah,
because,
I think
I
that
guess,
situation kind of
spooked
me. Going for that lead, but you know. That's not going to hit. So, in that situation, again, you know that that down air up here is not going to be true. So, you can use down air jump by weight. Either land or something after that.
Good back air catches. Well, again, it looked like Waugh was trying to come down with the back air. Well, he died now. This is game three. Last stock.
He taunts!
Even, and he taunted. Currently, Angel.
Waugh, I want to cheer for you so bad, but you're making yourself the villain.
The rapid jab, good parry, down throw, dash attack, into catches the.
Oh my god! All of these.
Oh, but he's gonna land on the platform.
Ways to get out of that were so preemptive. You have to be more patient. Yeah.
Well,
you know,
Tony
really
was working on a zero death, and now Waugh's got one in the making of his own.
So many
F smash
reads coming from Waugh's. Higher set. I would say all the hard reads he's making.
Again, here we go. Oh, down smash a little early. Waugh double jumps out of danger. The up smash on the spot dodge, and he comes back down
goodness.
The back air. And Tony takes it. Let's fucking go.
Your hubris lost you the game.
Taunt into. He didn't quite get bodied, but he did lose.
Yes. I think it was clear.
Captain Waugh taunted and took.